Hi everyone, Jeanette Biro here, helping you make sense of life in the world of spirit and woo. Now, the reason why I'm making these videos is because I want to help bridge this line of connection between things that happen in our 3D world and how those connect to spirit and the world beyond what we normally see, because we are infinitely connected. So today, the connector point I'm talking about is premonitions. Premonitions, because we have all heard of them or had them or been a part of them or something in that realm. And the question with premonitions is always like, what do we do with them, and how do we know what to do with them, and what is the deal with the timing of them? Because here's the deal. A premonition is a snapshot of the highest probable outcome at that point in time in which it is asked. So follow me. If you have a dream and that dream is a premonition of something, or if you go to a medium or a psychic or a channeler, whatever it may be, and they have a premonition of something, the time in which you get that premonition, that point in time, you are being given a snapshot of the highest probable outcome of the event. Now, if your premonition is of an event 6 months from now, then there is 6 months of time for variability and change to happen. So that's why sometimes premonitions that are way far out, there's such a shift and change in the timeline within it. Whereas premonitions that happen within hours before, moments before, even maybe just a day before, those often happen more accurate to the time, because again, the time in which you're being given the premonition is the highest probable snapshot. If you have less time from that initial snapshot to the time of it happening, there's less time for change. That's the biggest piece. Because if you think about it, if there's a premonition of somebody, something happening to somebody, if there's so much time in between that, that person has so many options of free will choices they can make that can either speed up their timeline to that premonition or delay it, or maybe even completely veer and alter the course of the event altogether. Because again, remember, within the world of spirit, nothing is black and white. Things are all these different shades of gray of potentials. So when you get a premonition or are given a premonition from somebody, remember it is a snapshot at that time. And then for how valuable that is, you want to know how much distance or time there is until the said premonition is going to occur, and then remember the variability in that, and that'll help you maneuver them with more ease. Because I know sometimes some people can get really caught up and hung up on a premonition, and it prevents them from living their best life. So this allows you to take your control and your power back with the things that you hear or the things that come your way, either through someone else or through dream state from spirit. So I hope that helps make sense of life in the world of spirit and woo and premonition specifically. And if you want to take a deeper dive with me into the world of spirituality, join me at the Jeanette Biro podcast. It's on all the major platforms, and I love doing the podcast. I have so much fun, so there's some great info on there. And as well, for everything else, course offerings, check out avalonspirit.com.